Hello friends, I am Rajgopal, faculty and legal practitioner, teaching something about the cyber law. Let us continue with today's agenda. Before that, let us discuss what we have discussed in the last sessions. So in the last session, we have discussed about the penalties, adjudication, compensation for the failure of the protected data, penalties for the failure to furnish the information return, residuary penalties, power to adjudicate, and the roles and responsibility of adjudicating officers. All these things we have discussed. So next, in today's agenda, let us discuss mainly about Cyber Regulation Appellate Tribunal. What is the Cyber Regulation Appellate Tribunal? It is an authority which will function, which will take up the cases related to the cyber crime. Anything which is related to the cyber crime, an appeal can be taken into the Cyber Regulations Appellate Tribunal. Okay. In this, let us discuss about the different sections which come under Cyber Regulations Appellate Tribunal, the establishment, composition, qualification of presiding officer of CRAT, that is CRAT means Cyber Regulations Appellate Tribunal, it can be called as CAT also, the term of office, salary and allowances, filling up of vacancies, filling up of vacancies, resignation and removal of presiding officer, staff of CRAT, appeal of CRAT, and procedure and powers of Cyber Regulations Appellate Tribunal and appeal to the High Court. Here, all these things were mentioned in IT Act 2000. Let us take one by one and which are all the legal provisions which will support all these facts, under which provision of IT Act 2000 these particular provisions are given to the person who will go for the CRAT, who will approach the CRAT. All these things let us discuss one by one today, my dear friends. So the first thing that we are going to discuss is Cyber Regulation Appellate Tribunal under Section 48 of Information Technology Act. So it has been established under the Section 48 of Information Technology Act. This is established by the central government. This is also an authority which is established by the central government to decide on the matters of cyber crime or cyber related issues. Okay. And the central government will specify the matters, which are all the matters that it has to take, and the jurisdiction of Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Okay. The jurisdiction means, my dear friends, every court will be having certain jurisdiction, means the area in which it can work. Okay, that we will call it as jurisdiction. For example, Bangalore District Court means it can take up the cases pertaining to the Bangalore District only. Mysore District Court means Mysore District. What are all the cases or the property suit or whatever may be which comes under the Mysore District jurisdiction will be taken by that particular court. Similarly, the High Court means entire Karnataka, Supreme Court means between the two states or whatever may be, entire India will be the jurisdiction. So, the jurisdiction means area in which a court can function. The cases pertaining to that area will be taken by that particular court or tribunal. Okay, that is known as the jurisdiction. The matters and the jurisdiction related to Cyber Appellate Tribunal under Section 48 will be decided by the central government. Similarly, in which are all the places the Cyber Appellate Tribunal has to be established? where the sitting has to take place, everything will be decided by the central government by the notification. Okay. So the next, section 48, section 49, composition of the cyber regulation appellate tribunal or cyber appellate tribunal under section 49. It contains one presiding officer. Quite naturally, the presiding officer will be appointed by the central government. The central government will appoint the presiding officer for the cyber appellate tribunal by its notification. Okay, there will be one presiding officer. There will not be any members along with the presiding officer. Only the presiding officer will be appointed. Okay, by the central government, and staff, supporting staff will be given under the directions of the presiding officer. The staff will function, okay, in cyber regulation appellate tribunal. Okay, similarly, section 50 will deal with what is the qualification of the presiding officer of cyber regulation appellate tribunal. The qualified to be a judge of high court. Okay, the person who should be appointed as the presiding officer for CAT should have a minimum qualification, or he should be an eligible to become the judge of high court. Means the high court judge, what is the qualification to become high court judge? That is, there are two qualifications. One thing is he should be in a judicial, he should have the judicial office for a tenure of 10 years. Judicial office, he should have 10 years, or he should be a practicing advocate for 10 years in High Court, any of the High Court. If he want to be a judge in High Court of Karnataka, in High Court of Karnataka, he should have a practice as an advocate for 10 years. And there is no minimum age limit to become the judge of the High Court. This is the qualification. The same qualification will hold good for becoming the presiding officer of cyber regulatory appellate tribunal or whatever may be. He should be a member of the Indian Legal Services. He should have an ID number of Indian Legal Service, and he should held or he should have hold a post of grade 1 in the service. Okay, that is the minimum qualification, and the age limit is there up to 65 years. It can be done. Okay, the term under section 51, hold the office for a term of 5 years or until he attains the age of 65 years. Okay, he should hold the office for 5 years. He can be a cyber presiding officer of CAT for 5 years. Or if he attains 65 years of age, then he will be retired from the post. Up to 65 years, he can be the presiding officer. Anyone is earlier, then he will be, he cannot continue in the office of cyber regulation appellate tribunal. Okay, under section 51 of Information Technology Act. Okay, next. Next, section 52, salary and allowances. As per the High Court judge, he will get the salary. He is eligible for salary, pension and gratuity, whatever the allowable allowances that can be given, that will be given to the presiding officer of the cyber regulation appellate tribunal. And then filling up of the vacancy. For the reason, if there is a vacancy, the vacancy will be created in any of the post by the resignation of the existing presiding officer, or by his retirement, or whatever may be the other conditions, by his death or whatever may be, a vacancy will be created. Section 53 of Information Technology Act will give a clear instruction how the vacancy can be filled. Okay, for the temporary reasons, for example, he may be on leave due to his personal reasons or whatever may be, then it cannot be treated as a vacancy. Okay, at that period, the Cyber Appellate Tribunal will not work during the period of his leave or whatever may be. After that, once he resumes the office, he come back to the office, once after the closure of his leave period or whatever may be, the Cyber Regulatory Appellate Tribunal will function normally. If there is a vacancy, permanent vacancy is created due to his resignation or superannuation or whatever may be, then the central government has the provision to appoint one more person of equivalent qualification to be a presiding officer of this CAT under section 53. And once if he resumes the power, whatever the cases which are filed in that period, whatever the cases which are pending will continue as per the proceedings. Okay, at that during the vacancy, no case will be disposed which are under the CAT. Okay, here there is no provision, there is no limitation period. Okay, there is no binding on the central government. It has to appoint the presiding officer within that particular time. Okay, so the central government may take its own time to appoint the presiding officer under this particular section, section 53 of IT Act. Okay, then the resignation and removal. Any high court judge can submit the resignation at whatever time he want by giving the proper reason to the central government. Okay, and for 3 months before only he has to give the resignation, or otherwise we can tell after giving the resignation he has to give 3 months time to give to the central government to relieve him from that particular post, from the post of presiding officer. Or otherwise, 3 months he should continue till further orders. Up to 3 months, he should continue in the post as the presiding officer. That is by the resignation. If the central government want to remove the presiding officer and it has to give a proper reasoning why he has to be removed, whether he had due to his proven misbehavior or inability to continue in the post as the presiding officer, by giving a proper reasoning with a proper procedure which is established, he can be removed from the post of presiding officer. The presiding officer shall not be removed as and when it is required. He cannot remove as and when it is required by the central government. Central government can appoint. Once if it wants to remove, there should be a proven misbehavior of that particular person. If he has involved in some unconstitutional activities, then that has to be proved. Then there is a proper procedure established. Okay, that has to be followed by the central government to remove him from the post of presiding officer until with that he will continue as the presiding officer in that particular office. Okay, that is under section 54 of Information Technology Act. Next, order constituting CRAT, section 55. Central government, once if it takes the decision to appoint the presiding officer, then nobody can question why he has been appointed on small grounds, small defects, nobody can question it. And the proceedings which take place before CRAT, nobody can question. Okay, that is section 55 of Information Technology Act will clearly tell that nobody should question the presiding officer or the proceedings of the CRAT for merely of any defect in the constitution of CREAT. Okay, that is under section 55 of Information Technology Act. Next, coming to 56, the central government will provide the staff, and staff should function under the superintendence of presiding officer, and central government will prescribe the salary and other allowances. The staff will be provided by the central government for the CAT, and the staff should work under the guidance of presiding officer, and the salary and all these other allowances will be prescribed by the central government under section 56 of CREAT rules. Okay, so under section 56 of Information Technology Act. Okay, next let us go to section 57. Appeal to Central Cyber Appellate Tribunal under section 57. Any person aggrieved by an order of controller can approach CREAT or CAT. Okay, under section 57. As we have discussed in the last class, there will be a controller for cyber related issues. Okay, there will be a controller. First thing is, we have to approach if there is any problem in digital signature certificates, in digital signatures, any contraventions in issuing the digital signature certificates. First, we have to approach the controller. Then afterwards, if there is any contraventions with the controller, then an appeal has to come to the CAT, Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Okay, that is the first point. No appeal shall by the order made by the adjudicating officer. The adjudicating officer cannot make an order to approach the Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Okay, and the next point is, the appeal should be filed within the 25 days of the order of the adjudicating officer. Once the adjudicating officer gives some order in some of the contraventions, within 25 days he has to approach the Cyber Appellate Tribunal. 25 days once after he issues the order, certified copies of the order is issued to a person, then within 25 days he has to approach the Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Okay, the opportunities will be given for unpredictable reasons. If that exceeds, if it becomes 30 days or 40 days, he has to give the proper reason. Then it is left to the presiding officer to accept the case. Okay, to accept the case, to take up the case before him for the adjudication. Okay, then within 6 months, the appeal should dispose. Once the appeal comes to the appellate tribunal, then there will be a 6 months time to dispose of the case. So with this point, I want to clarify one point, my dear friends. These tribunals are the quasi judicial authorities. Okay, quasi judicial system which has been established by a proper sections of a particular act, okay, to look into the particular area of the appeal. For example, there are KSAT, Karnataka State Appellate Tribunal, Administrative Tribunal, which will take up the administrative matter of the Karnataka, within the Karnataka administrative matter. For example, if the government employee has been harassed with an unnecessary transfer or whatever may be, that can be questioned in Karnataka State Administrative Tribunal. Similarly, Central Administrative Tribunal, any central government employee is denied of the increment, unnecessary harassment from the higher up or whatever may be, that will come under Central Administrative Tribunal. Similarly, there will be National Green Tribunal, which will take up the issues relating to the environment. If there is a damage to the environment by some factories or companies or whatever may be, that will be taken care by the Green Tribunal. Similarly, KAT, Karnataka Appellate Tribunal. Okay, any appeals relating to any of the issues like land, whatever may be, that will be taken by Karnataka Appellate Tribunal. Okay, similarly, these tribunals are quasi-judicial authorities which will look mainly into that particular area. Okay, into that particular area. The jurisdiction is that particular area. Administrative means entire administrative jurisdiction of the central government or state government, whatever may be. So, which will be established under the government act of the parliament. That will be established under the act of the parliament. Similarly, Cyber Appellate Tribunal is established by the Information Technology Act 2000. Okay, all these provisions will come under this particular tribunal. So let us continue with that. The last point is 6 months appeal. Within 6 months time, the appeal has to be disposed from the Central Cyber Appellate Tribunal from the Section 57 of Information Technology Act. If it exceeds, it is not that within 6 months it has to be disposed. Okay, due to some delay, if a proper opportunity has to be given to both the parties, while giving that, some time has to be given, a proper time has to be given, and it can be extended also. Okay, next section. Procedure and power of Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Not bound by the procedure of Civil Procedure Code 1908. Okay. It is not bound by the Civil Procedure Code, and it has to be given, it has to function based on the natural justice. It has the power to regulate its own procedure. It can give its own procedure, and it can decide the place at which it can have its sitting. Okay, that can also be decided. Here it means that there are some acts, functions as per other courts has to function. Okay, Civil Procedure Code 1908 will give the procedure under which a court has to function. Okay, but this CAT, Cyber Appellate Tribunal, is not bound, but it is having the powers, but it is not bound by the procedure of Civil Procedure Code 1908, but it has to function as the principles of natural justice. It has to function as the principles of natural justice. Okay, and it has the power to regulate its own procedure. Okay, and it can decide the place at which it will have its sitting. Okay, that is also decided by the CAT only under Section 58 of ID Act. Let us continue with that. Section 58 of Information Technology Act will give certain powers as per the Civil Procedure Code 1908. Okay, certain powers are there, and it will function as the civil court. Okay, it will function as the civil court. In civil court, there are some powers like summoning and enforcing. Okay, it can summon a particular person to attend the proceedings of the court. Similarly, the Cyber Appellate Tribunal has the powers to summon any person or any officer who is related to that particular case, and it can enforce that you have to come. Okay, it can enforce the attendance of a particular person to the before the Cyber Appellate Tribunal, and at the same time requiring the discovery and the production. Okay, it can production of the documents, it can enforce the production of document before the cyber appellate tribunal, and receiving the evidence of an affidavit. Okay, it can receive the evidence if somebody wants to submit some of the relevant evidences. Okay, it can receive the evidence through the affidavit, and issuing the commissions for examinations. Okay, it can issue the commissions. Okay, for the examination of the witness of the document. If there are some witnesses for the examination, it can issue the commission. And reviewing its decision. If some decision has to be reviewed, it has the provision, it can review its decision. Dismissing an application, it can dismissing the application for default or deciding it ex parte. If in any of the procedure of the civil courts, summons will be issued. Okay, both the parties should appear before the cyber appellate tribunal. If some party will not be present after a proper summoning, if he will not be present before the appellate tribunal, then it can decide the case on ex parte. Okay, it can dismiss the case on ex parte. Okay, it has the powers. And any other matter which may be prescribed, okay, any other matter which can be prescribed under this section, it can be decided. CAT is deemed to be a civil court. It will be deemed to be a civil court. All the procedures will be followed as per the civil court. It is having all the jurisdictions, okay, every provisions. Proceedings before the cyber appellate tribunal shall be deemed to be a judicial proceedings within the meaning of the section 193 and 228 for the purpose of the section 196 of Indian Penal Code. Okay, and the cyber appellate tribunal shall be deemed to be a civil court for the purpose of this section 195 chapter 25 of the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973, section 58. Okay, under that provision it can give impose fine under section IPCs, different sections of IPCs, and it is established under Code of Criminal Procedure also. Okay, so the CRAT is deemed to be a civil court. Okay, under the section 58 of Information Technology Act. Next, section 59, right to representation. In any of the court, this right to representation will be there. Here, an appellant can appear either in person, he can represent his own case. If he is familiar with the procedure of the court, with the sections, if different sections of the Information Technology Act and other related issues, he can present his case, his own case, or he can authorize. Okay, he can authorize one or the other, one or more legal practitioners. Okay, who can represent fluently before the CAT. Okay, Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Under section 59, he can present his own case, or he can make the legal practitioners, one or more legal practitioners, there can be a one legal practitioner or more legal practitioners, can appear before the presiding officer to represent any represent the case. Okay, or case before CRAT. Okay, the appellant may either appear in person or authorize one or more legal practitioner or any of its officers to present his case before the CRAT, okay, Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Okay, that is under section 59 of Information Technology Act. Okay, section 60 of Information Technology Act, limitations. The provisions of the Limitation Act 1963 shall, as far as may be, apply to the appeal made to the Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Okay, there is a Limitation Act, my dear friends, 1963, established in 1963, a Limitation Act. Limitation means, one example I will give here, a person A has given a loan of rupees 2 lakh or whatever may be to person B for a period of 2 years. There is a bounding that within 2 years he has to return the loan taken by person A. Person B has to return the loan. Then the person A will be bound for 2 years. After 2 years, person A has given the loan to person B. Person B has to return the loan to person A. So, the period is 2 years. He has to take back the money within 2 years. If the person B will not return the loan, then the question comes. If there is a right, you can approach the law. Okay, if you have any of the rights, you can. Wherever there is a right, there will be a remedy. Okay, you can approach the court. But there is a prescribed time. See, if you have given a loan to a particular person for a period of 2 years, if you have given the loan on May 2020, then within 2 years means by May 2022, he has to return the loan amount. But if he fails, then you can approach the court. If he fails, or if he tells that I will not return the loan amount that he has taken, then with proper evidence you can approach the court. Then there is a limitation up to what period you can approach. By 2022 he has supposed to return. Okay, you cannot approach the court by 2030. Okay, because there is no, you are legally eligible to take back the court, but you can't approach the court. Why you have waited up to that 8 years of time? You are bound to approach the court within 3 years. That is known as the limitation. There are different time periods given by the Limitation Act 1963. How you have upped, within what time you have to approach the court. Either it may be a high court or supreme court or whatever may be. Okay, within what period you have to approach the court. If there is an order from the lower court, okay, within how many days you have to approach the next court. Okay, if there is not a proper judgment in the particular lower court. Okay, so that is mentioned in the Limitation Act 1963. Anybody who want to approach any court or tribunal has to follow this Limitation Act 1963. Under this, Cyber Appellate Tribunal also, same Limitation Act will continue. Okay, same Limitation Act you have to look into for approaching this Cyber Appellate Tribunal under Section 60 of the Limitation Act of IT Act 2000. Okay, Section 61. Civil courts not to have the jurisdiction in this particular matter, in the cyber related issues. Okay, the civil court will not entertain any of the matter. Okay, no court shall have the jurisdiction to entertain any suit or proceeding in respect of any matter which an adjudicating officer has been appointed. No injunction shall be granted by any court, other authorities. No other authorities or courts shall issue the injunction. To stop any of the proceedings. No court shall be having the jurisdiction to give the injunction for a particular matter which is taken up by the Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Okay, so the next, That is under Section 61. Section 62. Any person aggrieved by the decision of CRAT, any tribunal for this matter, has to appeal before the High Court. Has to appeal before the High Court. You will be having the provision to appeal before the High Court. If you are aggrieved by the decision of the Cyber Appellate Tribunal, then under Section 62 of Information Technology Act 2000, you can go appeal to the High Court. You can approach High Court, but you have to appeal within 60 days from the date where you will receive the order from the Cyber Appellate Tribunal. The Cyber Appellate Tribunal will decide the case on one day. That is known as the date of decision. It will take some time. The Appellate Tribunal will take some time to type or to write the decision order, and that will be issued to you. You have to apply for a copy of the decision. It will be given to you. It will be handed over to you on one particular date. From the date where you will receive the order, from that date, 60 days time will be given to you to approach the High Court, to file before the High Court. That is under Section 62 of Information Technology Act. Recovery of penalty. That is the final section. If there is any penalty is imposed by Cyber Appellate Tribunal, it can be recovered. There is a recovery procedure will be there. It can be recovered as an arrear of the land revenue and other and the license. It can be recovered under this. Any penalty can be recovered if the opposite party will not approach the High Court, means some duration will be given. 60 days means 2 months. After 2 months, you can approach a relevant authority to recover that penalty. That is there under Section 64 of Information Technology Act. So, my dear friends, here, whatever we have discussed in the today's session is related to Cyber Appellate Tribunal. So this tribunal is established by the central government, which has all the provisions of the civil code. The proceedings can take place as per the proceedings of the civil code. Once the decision is given, if there is any penalty, that can be recovered by a proper procedure. And if somebody wants to go for an appeal, the person can approach the High Court. No other courts will be having the proper provisions. No other court will be having the jurisdictions to stop the proceedings or to question the proceedings of the Cyber Appellate Tribunal. Only the appeal should go to the High Court of that particular state. So this is about the Cyber Appellate Tribunal. With this we will conclude today's session. Again, my references are your prescribed book as per the Visveshwaraya Technological University and the Information Technology BARE Act 2000. With this, we will conclude this session. Thank you very much, my dear friends.